Peugeot just launched the new 2008. The car has changed a lot. When you look at the predecessor, it went from a crossover now into a real SUV. And today we'll have a closer look how the car drives, how it behaves, what about driver assistance and safety systems, what about the consumption. We're going to find out today. And we will have a closer look at the electric version as well. The 2008 is only 1.77 meters in width without the rearview mirrors. So the car works in the same class as the Skoda Kamiq, for instance, or the Kia Niro. But when you look at the front of the car, it looks a lot more massive, a lot more wider than it really is. And one reason for that are these lines here, because they all go from down up here, always to the outside of the car. It's the same here, it's the same down here, same on the other side. And that really gives the car the extra width. On top of this, we do find, yes, for sure, the 2008 signature here and the big Peugeot logo, but we do have this big grille here with these upright bars, and this gives the car the extra kick from the front, so a lot more pressure, not more power, and that really makes the car look more massive than it really is. Another thing quite important, the car always comes as standard with LED headlamps, but we do have the full LED package on board, and this is because we do drive the GT version. But if you choose a cheaper version, you can have this package as well. This is called GT Line package, and that'll cost you in Germany 2,100 euros extra. The iCockpit is something you will find in all the new Peugeots, and this is the same with that car here. And this is always a combination out of the digital cockpit, a small steering wheel, and the center instrument cluster, which is also digital. That comes as standard as a 7-inch, but you can have up to 10-inch. And so when you look into the digital cockpit here, this is the 3D version we're driving. That really delivers you the information you need a bit more on the top layer, which really gives you the opportunity to to get the information a lot quicker, which means if there is an alert coming, that's a lot more present than the other stuff, which really is something very nice. It's something you need to get used to, but it works very well. And on top, very important with that car is now Apple CarPlay and Android Auto are also always on board. Of course, the new 2008 is featuring the typical new Peugeot light signature, which not only means these three bars here, it also means this saber-tooth design down here. This is typical for the new Peugeots, and this is how you can really instantly recognize in your rearview mirror that you're followed by a new Peugeot. The 2008 comes quite nice equipped when we talk about the driver assistance and safety systems as standard. So for instance, you do find lane departure assist, you do find a front collision warning, you do find a speed limiter and a cruise control. But of course you can have a lot more. So you can have, if you want, a rear view camera, you can have an adaptive cruise control, you can have a real lane assist which keeps the car on the center of the road, and many, many more. So if you want, you don't have to miss anything regarding to this inside of the 2008. Regarding to the compartments in the car, you do find quite nice compartments in the doors at the driver and co-driver door. Which also fits bigger bottles. On top of this, you do have at the center console in the lower part an open, quite nice compartment, and in the upper part you do find something which you can close, which means you can just hide things nobody should see when somebody looks into the car from the outside. On top of this, you do have two cup holders in the center console and a small compartment beneath the armrest. Another thing which is, I think, quite important, you do find two USB sockets in the car, and one of those is the new one, the USB-C, and the other one is the USB-A, which means now you don't need an adapter if you want to charge your phone. The 2008 has grown a lot in length because the new version now is 14 centimeters longer than its predecessor. That means we're talking about 4.30 meters now. And the wheelbase has grown by 6 centimeters as well. But when we look at our car from the side, the first thing that catches your eyes, yes, these are 18-inch alloys. They are standard with the GT version, but if you buy the standard car, you will only find 16-inch. To make the car look a bit more like an SUV, you do of course find these wheel arch claddings here and the claddings on the side of the car to give the car a bit more robust look. When you look at the roof, we do have this black glossy roof mounted. This is standard with the GT version. If you don't buy that one, you may have to pay extra. When you look at the rest of the side of the car, what I really like is this shape here, because this really gives you the extra kick to the rear axle and gives the whole car a push to the forward, so it makes the car looking a bit more dynamic. And what I really like is this one here, because this line really ends at this three-dimensional taillights, a detail which I really do like. The seats of the 2008, they are really comfortable and, very important, they deliver loads of support, a lot more than I expected from an SUV. Sitting inside of the car, it's always something you have to get used to, because you do have this so-called eye cockpit, which means you do have a quite small steering wheel and you do not look into the cockpit through the steering wheel, you look over the steering wheel, which really is something, yeah, it works, but it's fresh and new, let's say it that way. But for me as a tall person, I have to say the steering wheel really cuts off a piece of the lower part of the cockpit. But that's not a big issue. It's just something you really do not expect, or something you need to get used to. You do find loads of glossy black surfaces inside of the 2008, like in the center console, which looks quite nice at first glimpse. But on one hand, you will instantly find every finger and thumb on it. And on the other hand, it is very easy to get scratches on it, so it does not look nice all the time, so you always have to polish it. And so you do find this in quite a lot of the modern cars, but it is for me not reason enough to really like it. With 1.53 meters in height, the car is now about 2 centimeters lower than its predecessor, which gives an extra bit of dynamic. But when we look at the rear of the car, what I really like, as said on the side, is these three-dimensional taillights, of course with this three claws here, typical Peugeot, by the way, as standard with LED technology. Between the two of them, you have this glossy black part here. Yeah, I think it's something we really have to look at. Very nice that we do not find the triangle shape on the side, front and rear. We also find it at the back of the car. And then you do find the Peugeot signature here, the logo of Peugeot down here. But I think at the rear, something that really catches your eyes is this, I think, quite massive bumper with this two exhaust in there. My first test drive with the 2008 was in the 155 horsepower petrol version, and that car comes with an 8-speed automatic as standard. And I have to say, yes, the engine and the gearbox, that really works well, so you can drive the car quite sporty, so very loads of fun. But when you really do a kickdown, the car needs a second or two before it really accelerates, but then it's really great fun. And when you switch the car into sports mode, of course, the car not only gets a bit more stiffer, more crisp, also the sound of the car changes. And then you find a noise which really reminds you a bit of a smaller, quite aggressive sports car, something I do really like. When we talk about the fuel consumption, that car should take 5 liters per 100 kilometer driven regarding to the data sheet. But during our test drive, where we really drove, I would say, normal, our car took about 7 liters. Another thing you do find in all the new Peugeots is this, I would say, keyboard, which is mounted below the touchscreen. You do have some buttons at the top of it, which gives you the opportunity to directly change between, let's say, radio and sat nav and all this stuff. And the other ones are here to control the climber, to set the warnings on, and to go back to the main menu. The starting price of the 2008 is €21,500 in Germany. With this, you get the 1.2-liter petrol engine with 100 horsepower and manual transmission. A 90-horsepower Skoda Kamiq with a 1-liter 3-cylinder is available from as little as €18,000. It also comes with a manual gearbox and is, like the Peugeot, front-wheel powered. Who is interested in a Kia Niro must spend at least €26,990. But then gets 141 horsepower from a hybrid drive and a dual-clutch transmission.
I didn't drive the diesel, the 130 horsepower version of the 2008, but I talked to some of my colleagues and they told me they drove the car and they said the car should take 3.8 liters per 100 kilometer driven, but during their test drive, while normal driving, they used about 6 liters.
When the 2008 will hit the market, there will be only three different engines available in principle, because we will have a 1.2 liter petrol engine and that offers either 102, 131 or 155 horsepower. Very important here is to know the smallest one always comes with a 6-speed manual gearbox. The middle one, you can choose between the manual and an 8-speed automatic gearbox, and the bigger one always comes as standard with the 8-speed automatic gearbox. On top of this, you do find a 1.5-liter diesel engine, which always comes with an 8-speed automatic, and for sure you do find the electric version as well. This then offers 100 kilowatts or 136 horsepower.
The 2008 is, yeah, made as an SUV, which means we do find quite a high shoulder line, and which this means we do find quite small windows. But nevertheless, this car is an SUV. It doesn't really feel like an SUV, because when you sit in the car, you really sit quite deep in the car. And on the other hand, even though we're talking about this high shoulder and the small windows, you really have a quite nice surround view. What I really do like is a detail here when you look at the instrument cluster of the cockpit, because the side of it is open. This is a very nice but small detail. And you do find as well something like this chrome bar beneath the sat-nav, or you do find these very nicely shaped air outtakes here. They're really looking into the car, and you will find more and more of these small bits and pieces, which really lifts the impression of this interior to the next level. The boot size has grown, because now the 2008 delivers 405 liters with the rear seats up. This is about 55 more than with the predecessor. When you fold down the rear seats, that increases to 1467 liters as maximum. And you do find this variable floor here, which you can open. And with this one, you can define how you want to use the space of your boot. The 2008 really drives very nice. The steering is quite precise and the suspension is very good. And what I really do like with the car, it's very quiet inside of the car, which means you do normally not hear anything. Of course, it's an electric engine, so no noise there, but the rest of the car is also very quiet. The only thing you hear at the moment are the tires, because the road is not perfect. But if you drive on a quite nice surface, you will not even hear the tires as well. Another thing which I really do like is the battery is in the underfloor of the car, which means you do find exactly the same amount of space inside of the car as well as in the boot if you compare that to the petrol or the diesel version. So it's with all of the cars, it's exactly the same amount of space.
With its 405 to 1467 liters of boot capacity, the Peugeot is well equipped. The Skoda Kamiq offers 400 liters with the rear seats up and a maximum of 1,395 liters of luggage capacity with the rear seats fold down. With 436 to 1,435 liters, the Kia has a little more to offer, but also can't win regarding to the maximum load volume.
The electric 2008 is powered by a 100 kilowatt or 136 horsepower electric engine, and that delivers me 260 newton meters of maximum torque, but from rev zero onwards, which means you can drive the car quite dynamic if you want, and that really delivers loads of fun then. With its 50 kilowatt hour battery on board and a consumption of 17.8 kilowatt hours per 100 kilometer driven, regarding to the data sheet, the car should have a range of 320 kilometers as maximum with a fully charged battery. During our test drive, we came close to the amount of under 18 kilowatt hours per 100 kilometer driven. But what was interesting was when we started with our car, it showed us with a fully loaded battery a maximum range of 240 kilometers. So I would say if you drive the car day to day and you drive it maybe in bad weather conditions, or you may drive it a bit more dynamic, you should better expect instead of 320, about 250 kilometers of maximum range with a fully charged battery.
You instantly recognize that you look at an electric version of the 2008 when you look at the front, because the grille, these parts here, they come in the same color as the rest of the car. And on top of this, the lion comes in two colors.
The materials and the craftsmanship of the 2008 are quite nice. So you do find soft touch here at the upper parts. You do find, of course, some plastic down here. But on top of this, you do have this part here, which is at the dashboard. It looks a bit like, yeah, carbon fiber, and that gives the car quite a fresh look. You find very nice stitching, and with a stitching color, you can exactly see what kind of car you're driving. With our electric now, this is green, and I think this really matches the idea of an electric car quite well. The space the car offers is really nice. As you can see, I sit quite upright and I do still have some head space left. I have enough elbow room. And so even for a tall person, this car is really nice and comfortable. But how much space is left behind me, we're gonna find out during a short stop. So this is the short stop as promised. I didn't change my seating position. Now let's see if I can climb in behind me. It looks tight. Oops. But good news is I do fit in.
Another good news, I do have enough headspace. As you can see with my knees and my feet, that's quite tight, but I do sit behind me, I'm nearly 2 meters tall. So I think, yeah, for a short distance that works, and if there's a standard person at the front, standard person at the rear, I think for a small SUV, that's quite okay.
The electric version of the 2008 offers you different recuperation modes, which means you do find one where the car behaves, yeah, just like an automatic car, so with an automatic gearbox, which means you get your foot off the pedal and the car just rolls, so very easy and smooth. On the other hand, you can have one which I would call one pedal drive, which means when you get your foot off the pedal, the car instantly reduces speed like a soft brake, and so it recuperates energy. And this gives you the opportunity, if you really drive carefully and look far forward while driving, you can just drive without using the brake at all.
The base price of €35,250 for the electric Peugeot 2008 seems to be right high. However, if you check, for example, the prices of the Kia e-Niro, you will find out that the basic version also already costs over €35,000.
Important for the electric version of the 2008 is, yes, it features a thermal heat pump, which really gives you a better, yeah, let's say, fuel efficiency, especially when you want to heat up the car in winter.
That was my test drive in the new Peugeot 2008. And when you look at the exterior, I really do like it a lot because that's very modern and fresh. And especially when you look at the predecessor, that car really has grown, so it looks like an adult now. Regarding to the space at the interior at the front, you do sit very comfortably, even me as a tall person, but behind me it works, but this is nothing, yeah, it's not a wonderland regarding to space. Talking about the price, the car starts at €21,500 in Germany. I think that entrance price is absolutely fine, but when you talk about the electric version, that starts at €35,000. And this is quite high for such a small car, but if that works or not, let's see when the car arrives at the market.